In the beginning, I had no clue how to solve this. Keeping up with the Commodore, because the Commodore is keeping up with you. In a world of fun and fantasy, an ever-changing views, and computer terminology. My cousin had a C64. I guess he kind of grew tired of it, or he got a new and better machine back in the 90s. So I sort of inherited his C64 and all of the diskettes. And I didn't realize the potential of the machine at the time. So I basically just loaded up a bunch of games. I found a couple of games that became favorites. And I would play them, but I would like fall in love with the music. I always thought the music was so good, even to this day. It wasn't until recently, like a couple of years ago, that I actually started using it to make music. The technology of today is amazing, but it can also be really hard to deal with if you're trying to do something unconventional. A lot of the stuff that I do is heavily influenced by the C64 and just that whole era of music and graphics. It might not be obvious immediately to whoever sees our stuff or hears it, but I draw a lot of inspiration from that. And touring today, I get to use that. So our visuals are obviously inspired by old school graphics. I can bring that into what we do by having that on screen when we play our shows. So a lot of our visuals for shows are pixel art, which I think is awesome. I love the fact that I can do this, that I can use like old pieces of hardware and somehow integrate and convert my first and some of my most important influences, turn it into a modern day entertainment package.